Hello. Android became more and more popular as an operating system for high-end portable audio players, and few more and more interesting models appears. In this review, I will focus on the medium-tier models that were released relatively recently. That's these three models, and also I've added Fuse X7 first generation because it's really close in the terms of price to these three models. But and you can actually purchase it still, so it's making it also player that is fitting this price range. I will try to make some really subjective comparison and highlight strengths of these models, and probably compare their specifications. Let's start in the price order from the most affordable to the most expensive. And the most affordable model will be Hydis AP200. Actually, most affordable is Fuse X7. Now it's sold on eBay for $290, but you will need to spend about $100 for the amp module because it's sold without amplification module. So this player will be later. So Hydis made the most affordable DAB, but it's actually looking nice. Inexpensive version made of aluminium. It's available in three colors. Back panel is glass-like, and also there is a stainless steel version. It cost more, but it has more onboard flash memory. This one has only 32 GB, and stainless steel version offers different back panels: wooden, carbon, and so on. So, as you can see, it's one of the smallest. Let's compare sizes this way. It's shorter. It's pretty narrow. Feel wider, for example. Let's see. But actually, it's thicker. So, but it's still lightweight and pretty pocketable. Not many controls. Just three buttons. This tool is for volume, and the double click is for track navigation. Play pause button, on off, and just one micro SD slot, USB Type-C, and single headphone output. It also can be used as a line-out. It has a really good bright screen with nice viewing angles and nice colors. For operating system, all these models uses Android 5.1.1, and it uses shell made by Hibi. You can select full featured Android with Play Store, or you can switch to the pure music mode and where only music player is available. So it's common for all those models, actually. Feature wise, it's a pretty good player. It has Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, and another feature that we expect. It's capable of output audio via USB, but some features are lacking. For I've covered this in the review, but probably they will be added and fixed in the future software upgrades. Also, there are few minor lags. Not critical, but sometimes there are some glitches in some rare conditions, but they are present. But I think they will be fixed. And it's probably the shortest in terms of battery life, but actually its difference isn't big. Average for these DAPs is about from 8 to 10 hours, but this one is a bit less than 8 hours. But actually, X7 is dependent on amplification models. With some models, it's also pretty below than the 8 hours. And sonically, it's a pretty interesting player with a bit smooth representation, accented lows, and accent on treble. It's the simplest in terms of resolutions of all those models. But for $300, it's pretty nice. It's not super resolving and offers a bit smoother presentation, but resolution is still nice. It plays okay with poorly recorded tracks, so in this terms, it's pretty convenient and its sound is still really worth this price. Next one in terms of price, it's Kane N5 second revision. First revision of Kane N5 was absolutely different app without Android, with proprietary operation system, but they made really worth upgrade. Here used also yes Sabre chip, but only single one. If I remember right, it's 9018K2M, so it's probably a bit better, or maybe not better. Actually, it doesn't matter what chips are used inside, it's the matter how it sound overall. There are more controls here, it's on-off button. Here is present balanced and single-ended output that also can be used as line out. Three buttons to control playback and wind track navigation. Two microSD slots. And if I remember right, too, it has 32 gigabytes of flash memory. And also USB-C. It's also pretty universal in terms of functions. It supports Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and so on and so forth, and it's capable of output audio via USB 2. Via this USB, you can access USB on the go flash drives. You can output via special cable coaxial signal. So a lot of features. Also, please see link in description if you'd like it to cover in depth. And the operation system here is a bit different. You won't have the fully functional Android launcher here, just a special built-in launcher, and but you can Google Play service is available here, and you can install third-party software, but it's placed in special menu, so no access to the desktop, no launcher, but it's still, I think it's a matter of preferences. Also, here is present Pure Music mode, where all wireless interfaces will be disconnected. All background processes not related to audio will be shut down, and you can enjoy just the music. So it's pretty fast. There are less glitches. Actually, as you can see, size-wise, it's the narrowest DAP, so I think it's the most pocketable one. It's a bit longer than, for example, actually not longer, it's the same, has the same length as Fio and close width, but Fio is narrower, wider, and Kane N5 is narrower. So, sonically, this is very natural device with pretty powerful output, especially balanced ones, so you can drive even pretty power hungry headphones, and it's natural, it's resolving with a great imaginary stage with good layering and so on and so forth. Its sound is probably the closest to the audiophiliac. Also, X7 is close if you select, for example, AM3 amplification model, but actually this one is pretty natural, and it's critical to the quality of the recording. So if you're listening to some higher-end IEMs, if you like, for example, Armature sound, if you like to see uncolored representation without any added emotions and so on and so forth, then this Kane is a nice option for you. Actually, Kane is really great manufacturer of high-end gear. They recently introduced interesting $4,000 tube headphone amplifier, and they offer a lot of another interesting gear for those who like headphones. But N5 too is a really nice DAP, and I'm actually waiting with impatience what they will do next with their more expensive models, so they need to replace N6 too. Probably they will use Android too, so let's see. And actually, it's also one of the longest living players. It can give you from 9 to 11 hours of work time. It depends on load and on the usages, but it's probably the longest living here. It's a bit surprising, but next in price ascending order, it is Fio's X flagship model X7, first generation. Fio released it 2 years ago, And after that they released a second revision, but and now this one is sold with good discounts. You can get it from AliExpress or from Amazon with for a really good affordable price. It's about a bit less than $400 with some amplification model. It features, besides everything else, replaceable amplification models, which you can use to adapt sound and get proper power of amplification for your needs. So I've made reviews of amplification models and of this player, so as usual, welcome to the description for more links. Design is pretty simple, so as you can see, two set of buttons from two sides, on off. This one is for volume, this is play pause, tracks navigation, here is interesting LED indicator, sensor screen. On the top there is a line out and coaxial out, and a set of inputs and outputs defined by the amplification module you are using. It is a stock AMP1 module, so it's relatively simple, but there are better models that really improve sound quality. For example, I suggest using AM2 or AM2A. I like, at least subjectively, I like them most. And only one micro SD slot, so just one SD card. Firmware wise, it's the same as Fios X5-3 and the same as X7 of second generation, so Fio using same code base, providing same features. And they developing this firmware for a few years already. It's based on Android 5.1.12, but they offering pretty mature firmware. They are polishing it and they are constantly squashing bugs, offering a lot of nice features and so on and so forth. And they pretty frequent in updates, so they really improved firmware since the first version they've released it. Battery wise, it depends on amplification tools. With this one it's more than 8 hours, with AM2 for example it's about 8 hours, with powerful models like AM3 and AM5 it's about 7 hours, but it is a price of added power. Another nice feature of Fio DAPs, it is a wide range of different accessories. Fio creates for them different cases, stacking kits, dock station, desktop amplifier with dock module K5, Bluetooth remote control and many other stuff like that. So with it you will have the best possible set of accessories. Sonic signature really depends on the amplification module you will be using, but I'm using AM2 as some reference, and it offers really resolving sound with a hint of warmth, which added more body to the music, but just a little hint with perfect mid resolution, maybe not perfect, but really good mid resolution, nice really layered treble. So sonically it's probably the best dub of all these four. So if you're okay with using pretty big player, as you can see it's really bulky, if you care only about sound quality, I really suggest you to consider X7 first generation if you can get it for the price that it's sold on Amazon, for example, and invest another $100 into amplification module. So it's probably the most mature sound of all those three, pretty normal firmware and so on and so forth. So I think it's sonically it's the best option here. The last one, but definitely not the least, it's recently updated Fio X5 third generation. Two previous generation of Fio X5 DAPs really prove themselves being very convenient DAPs with good sound and so on and so forth. For the third revision they also adopted Android as operation system and created really stylish design that brings them few design awards. IFA Design Awards and some others. They're using some ideas from Mastel and Kern design, but they using also their own design ideas. Player is available in two colors, if I remember right, this black one and red one, and definitely it's most stylish of all these dubs. Here is this beveled edge with navigation on off, not on off, play pause button, and here is volume wheel. And here is on off button with LED indicator, two micro SD slots, so you can use really a lot of memory. And there are line out, headphone out, and balanced output. FIO didn't adopt USB-C yet, so it's just regular micro USB, but it's compatible with FIO docks, with FIO adapters, so it's also you can use it with all this FIO's accessory set. Firmware here is same as in other FIO dubs, it's stable, it's pretty stable, so Android can't be really stable, especially old version of Android. There are some issues, but these issues, actually, at least for me, they are really at some really itch conditions, so I can't call them some big issues. So main usage of these dubs, it's music playback, and music playback is stable and pretty reliable. So what else I can add about this player? It has a normal battery lifetime from 8 to 9 hours plus minus. Offers pretty normal output power, enough for almost all headphones. It uses AK digital to analog converters, so it's the only player in this comparison that isn't using Saber DACs. And it offers own pretty interesting sound signature. Sonically it's a bit smooth, but actually it's actually maybe even not smooth, but with added forms and with added accents on lower frequencies, and it gives this sense of warmth to overall sonic representation. But it's not sound muddy, it's not sound darken, it's not sound, I don't know, unnatural. It's a really interesting organic representation for those who like a bit warmer sound. Treble here is also present, and it's pretty defined, pretty nice, so I can't call this player treble shy, for example, or model for those who don't like treble, because treble here is present and it's also nice, but it's a bit warmer in terms of signature. Actually, it's not as smooth as, for example, Hedis AP200, it's more resolving, but warmer representation here is present. So, to summarize this review, all these four dubs are really good, and if you care just about sonic quality, then you can select FIO X7. If you like natural and resolving, natural and uncolored sound, then K&N 5.2 is for you. If you would like warmer sound signature and good design, then FIO X5.3 is for you and or another option. And if you are low on your budget and you're looking for some inexpensive solution, then Hedis AP200 is also a nice option for you. So I will probably do another video including some other dubs in this price range, but without Android, so it will be bigger comparison, but it will be a bit later when I'll get some new upcoming models. So here is four dubs with Android operating system if you need it, if you like to use some streaming, for example, and so on. So I suppose I will help you to make some decisions. Thank you for attention.